was the early 1900s. Machines were starting to replace people, and factories were popping up everywhere. Employing children in these factories was cheap and a good way to help ramp up production. But the textile mill was not a safe place. The machines would constantly take off fingers, and the oak floors worn by the metal-wheeled carts would put splinters into the barefooted children's feet. It was the child mill workers' right to be safe and healthy. It was also their right to be able to go to school and learn. It was the responsibility of the mill to give that to them. They took the innocence away from their child laborers and ruined the possibilities of their education. The mill had took and transformed them into men and women without letting them grow up. The textile mill had stolen their childhoods.
The children all grew up on land. They never went to school. They never learned to read and write, but learned to spin and spool.
It was the Industrial Revolution that started it all. The population kept increasing, but thriving childhoods did not. There were not many opportunities to go to school, and children were expected to work. This is a sample of what a child's day might look like in the mill. A normal workday for a child would start at 5 a.m. and go till 6 p.m. 5 a.m., the morning whistle blows. 5:30, a second whistle blows, letting the workers know they have 25 minutes until they're needed at work. 6. A final whistle blows, all the workers are at their stations. The machinery started at 5:55 a.m., along with the mill's windows being opened. 12 o'clock noon, the whistle sounds and the machinery stops, signaling the 55-minute lunch period. Usually at this time, children would eat their meals and play outside. At 12:55, the machines are restarted. The 1 p.m. whistle sounds, and the morning work process repeats in the afternoon. These children, who were working the same amount as their adult counterparts, were getting paid half as much for doing the same jobs for the same amount of time. By 1900, 25% of all Southern mill workers were children between the ages of 10 and 16. This shows that a lot of children chose work over school. Most children did not have a choice to work. Either they were orphans sold off as slaves, or they needed to help pay the bills of their families. These children, who might have worked a 64-hour work week, were allowed to keep maybe 25 cents of their wages, if any, after household expenses were taken care of. Many children look forward to becoming the age to work in the mill as a way of getting out of the hot and backbreaking work of farming, while others preferred to remain on the farm. The choice, however, was not theirs to make. If it had been, all the women I talked to would have chosen to be in school. Since these mills paid so bad, families had no other choice than to send their kids off to work at the factories. One of the worst things about the mill was how dangerous it was. The machinery could be operated by children, but it was still not safe. Children lost feet, legs, and arms constantly. Kids were formed into adults as soon as they started working. They were being depended on to fund their family, just as their parents were. They never got to live a healthy, fun childhood. These kids had a lot of stress, not only from exhaustion, but from the thought of their family not having enough money. This created bad adult-like behaviors. Kids would smoke cigarettes and cigars, and some would even drink. They saw this as okay, because in a way, they thought of themselves as adults. Since the kids were working all the time and had no time for education, their opportunities passed. With no schooling and no experience, other than manual labor, they were stuck working in the mills for their whole life. As the Constitution says, we have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. These children did not get a fair life. They were not able to live in a healthy environment or work in a healthy environment. They were not able to pursue their dreams and achieve their goals because they had no education.
When things went wrong, their bosses often frowned. Many times those little ones was kicked and shoved around. Come out of bed, little sleepyhead, get your bite to eat.
The factory whistle's calling you. There's no more time to sleep.